Abdul Karim from Lahore, Pakistan. If all the Muslims believe in the same Quran and the same Hadith, then why are there four madhabs and why do they differ? This is a very important question and a very sensitive question. I do agree that as far as the Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat is concerned, major chunk of the Muslims, all of us believe in the same Quran, we believe in the same Hadith, we believe after the Quran is the Bukhari, the most important, then Sahih Muslim is there, then you follow the Qutb al-Sitta, that Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, then Ibn Majah, Sunan Nasa'i, these four are the main collection of the Qutb al-Sitta, and there is unanimous agreement between this, the Quran, and the Qutb al-Sitta. Number one, after the Quran is Bukhari, the Muslim, and then the other four books of Hadith. Regarding the question, that why are there four madhabs and why do they differ? As far as the four popular madhab that we have today and we follow the four imams, that is Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi and Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, may Allah have mercy on them all. I love all these four imams, I respect them all, and I really pray for all of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them mercy, and may Allah put all of them in Jannat al-Firdaws Salala. Let me correct you first, that these four madahib, they came to explain to the Muslim Ummah Islam in detail. Let me tell you that they don't differ always. They differ rarely. More than 90 to 95% all the four madhab are the same. They may differ in some issues, maybe minor issues. As far as the major issues are concerned, about Salah we have to purify time, regarding Zakat, regarding Hajj, all these four madhab, they are same. In the minor aspects of Salah or of Hajj, they may differ here and there, but they are minor differences. It's not a major difference at all. It is not worth fighting over it. All these four ulamas, they said that if you find any of my fatwa, any of my verdict, which goes against Allah and His Rasul, which goes against Quran and Sahih Hadith, then you throw my fatwa on the wall. So all these four Aimas, they were great scholars, and they came to explain the deen to us. Regarding why do they differ, if we follow the same Quran and the same Hadith, is a very important question, and this question troubled me for many years. Alhamdulillah, Allah has blessed me that I have met many scholars from all these four madhahib, and I interacted with many of them many hours, and I spent time with them, and I posed the same question, why do they differ? And the reply they gave was there, some less satisfying, some more satisfying, but there was no convincing reply for the masses. And Alhamdulillah, Summa Alhamdulillah, after meeting these scholars from all these four madhahib, my vision of Islam and the differences, Alhamdulillah, expanded a lot. Allah clearly mentioned in the Quran in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 103, وَاتَسِمُوا بِحَبِّلَّهِ جَمِيعُ وَلَا تَفْرَقُوا. Hold to the rope of Allah strongly and be not divided. We Muslims are supposed to hold to the rope of Allah, that the glorious Quran and the Sahih Hadith. To explain to a common man, I will give you some examples, and I always believe in explaining people by giving example will they understand. I would like to ask a simple question to the people who know English. What is the spelling of the word color? Can you guess? Give the reply. You can give the reply on the WhatsApp, you can give the reply on the Facebook, you can give the reply on the YouTube. What is the spelling of color? I'm not very good to reply. What is the spelling of color? What is the spelling of color? Some may say the spelling of color is C-O-L-O-U-R. Some may say the spelling of color is C-O-L-O-R. Which is correct? A person who is very versed with English will tell you that the first spelling is the spelling of British English. C-O-L-O-U-R is the British spelling for the word color. C-O-L-O-R is the American spelling for the word color. I am asking the question, which is correct? C-O-L-O-U-R or C-O-L-O-R? And again, we'll have different opinion. Some will say C-O-L-O-U-R is correct if you're the British. Some will say C-O-L-O-R if you're an American. Some will say both are correct. But even if they differ, you never find them fighting over this issue. When they differ, a Britisher will say C-O-L-O-U-R is correct. I'm an Indian. We were ruled by the Britishers, and quite a large portion of the world was ruled by the Britishers. So all those who were ruled by the Britishers and we were British colonies, we will follow British English and we will say the spelling of correct C-O-L-O-U-R. The American will say C-O-L-O-R. We agree to both. A Britisher would prefer C-O-L-O-U-R, but if someone says C-O-L-O-R, fine. We agree to differ. Same with the American, he will say C-O-L-O-R, but he agrees. He believes that is better, but he agrees with C-O-L-O-U-R also. Similarly, this is just an example I've given you. How do you pronounce O-F-T-E-N? How do you pronounce O-F-T-E-N? Some will say often, some will say often. Previously was often, then it became often. Now new people are saying often is correct. T is not silent, it should be pronounced. Some say T is silent, and then there's a big debate for that. But we realize that both are correct in their own ways. Similarly, these schools of thought, four that we have, actually, there were many tens and hundreds of imams and scholars. These four, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, may Allah have mercy on them all, may Allah grant them Jannat al-Firdaus to all, they were more popular. Or maybe Westerners made them popular. There were many other imams, many other sheikhs, many other scholars. But these four, their teachings became more popular. Maybe the students made it more popular. And that's how we have these four major madahibs. But all these four great scholars and four ahmas, they never came to bring a division in the Muslim Ummah. They explained their point of view. Because if it's very clear cut in the Quran, there is no problem at all. If it's clear cut in the Hadith, the difference comes when there is a difference of opinion. Now, why is there a difference of opinion? I will discuss that. Previously, I should think, okay, fine, you know, maybe the difference is in the Hadith. Some people say Sahih Hadith, some people Zayf Hadith, that is the difference. That is not the real answer. That may be in some cases. After meeting so many fuqahas and scholars of these different madahib, I've come with this example of the spelling or the example of pronunciation. So similarly, the madahib differ. What is the major reason? According to my study, there is usul fiqh, that in areas where it is not very clear cut, Quran says alcohol is haram, there is no fiqh in it. Allah says haram, it is haram. So no one will differ allowed or not allowed. That's wrong. Where there is difference in understanding the Quran or the Hadith, etc., then the fiqh start. So as far as usul fiqh is concerned, there are different criteria for giving a ruling on fiqh. Some may have 5 criteria, some may have 6, some may have 7, some may have 9, some may have even 10. I will not discuss in detail, time does not permit and difficult for common men to understand. I will give a few examples for better understanding. Number one difference is difference in the criteria. As far as the first two criteria are concerned, it is the same. Number one criteria in all madahib, all schools of thought, it is Quran. Number one, there is no difference in it. Number two is the mutawatir hadith. All the schools of thought believe that number two criteria for fiqh is the mutawatir hadith. What is the mutawatir hadith? There are various different classifications of hadith. One of the classifications is depending upon the narrators, the chain of narrators. Mutawatir hadith means a hadith in which there are various chains of narrators in every generation. That means that hadith has been narrated by various, many sahabas who heard the Prophet say that. Then the next generation tabi'in, there were many tabi'in who repeated that hadith. Then the tabi'in tabi'in, many tabi'in tabi'in repeated the hadith. So in every generation there are various many narrators. So in one of the classification of hadith, it is based on narrators.
it is maybe a Garib Hadith, a single chain of Hadith. Then this Ahad Hadith, one narrator is there at any one stage, only one narrator. For example, the very famous Hadith, the first Hadith of Sahih Bukhari, Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, that the Prophet said, innamal amal binniyah. Your actions are based on your intention. All you find this Hadith in Bukhari, in Muslim, in many books of Hadith, but there is only one Sahaba who narrated it. So if any of the stages, where the stage of Sahaba, or the Tabi'in, or Tabi'in, Tabi'in, any of the stages of narration, if any of the stages are only one narrator coming in all the Hadith, it becomes Ahad Hadith. So there are various chains of narrators, but all the narrators end to Umar radiallahu anhu, and then Umar radiallahu anhu narrated what the Prophet said. So it becomes Ahad Hadith. It may be a Mashhur Hadith, if there may be two or three narrators, and it keeps on various category. The highest category is mutawatir, that means several narrators at every stage. That means every stage has many narrators. Number of it has to be more than 4 or 5. Every stage. Some are 20, some are 30 at every stage. So number one is the Quran. Number two is the mutawatir hadith. All the schools of thought agree that the number two highest category of evidence after the Quran is the mutawatir hadith. Third category onwards, the third criteria of evidence differs in different schools of thought. Some have 5 criteria, some have 6, some have 7, some have 10 criteria. In some schools of thought, the third criteria, highest criteria of evidence is even ahad hadith. As long as it's a sahih hadith, even ahad, no problem. It can be a mashhur hadith, it is the third highest. In some schools of thought, no. The third after the mutawatir hadith is the urf, is the custom. That if the people of Medina did this act, it is the custom, it is the third highest, higher than even a sahih hadith, which is the ahad hadith. Some will say no. It is qiyas, analogy. So different schools of thought have different criteria in order. First two is the same, the third may be a sahih ahad hadith, some may say no urf, the custom, some may say qiyas, analogy. Other group, the fourth becomes ahad hadith, the fourth becomes custom in some schools of thought. So from the third onward, it differs. So based on this difference, some may prefer custom as a higher. So if it is not there in the Quran, if it is not there mutawatir hadith, it is an ahad hadith. So this school of thought is ahad hadith. The other say, it is an ahad hadith, but it is not the urf. So I will not believe, I will give urf more importance, custom more importance. So the differences arise in what you give more importance to. Do you give importance more to urf, the custom? Do you give more importance to qiyas, analogy? Or do you give more importance to ahad hadith? From third level it keeps on differing in different schools of thought. So because of that, what you give more importance to differs, that's how the ruling differs. But all these rulings are minor. One has to understand that we have to respect the ruling of all the four schools of thought. Because all the four schools of thought are based on Quran, they are based on Hadith, but the level of importance may differ. Some schools of thought say, they may have a criteria, if you are talking about Salah, it should be a mutawatir Hadith. Because Salah, the Prophet prayed in public, almost all the Sahabas saw him. So if you give about Salah, Ahad Hadith, though it is Sahih, I will not follow. If it is Salah, it has to be evidence from mutawatir Hadith, otherwise I will not follow. That is their thinking. You may agree, you may not agree. You may say, no, it's Ahad Hadith, one Sahaba reported it is sufficient for me. It's a Sahih Hadith, fulfill the criteria of Sahih, it is sufficient for me. Other scholars said, no, if it's other matter, I will believe in Ahad Hadith. But Salah, such an important thing, Prophet prayed every day, 5 times a day, it should be a mutawatir Hadith. Difference of opinion. So how do you differ? So the third and the fourth and the fifth level of criteria after the first two differ, this is the reason why the major difference is there in the four schools of thought. It may be difficult for people to understand. Number two, the difference may also be that you may differ that whether it's a Sahih Hadith or not. Some may say it's a Hasan Hadith. Hasan Hadith is the lowest level of Sahih Hadith. Some will say no, it is a Daif Hadith. So Daif Hadith is not a hujjah, is not an evidence for saying something is fard or something is haram. It may have other values. So the Muhaddithin may differ, and when they differ, they differ minor. Some may say Hassan, some may say Zaif. Hassan is the lowest category of Sahih. Classifying Hadith on the basis of whether the Sahih, Zaif, or Mawzu is another classification. Sahih Hadith itself, there are 10 types of Sahih Hadith. Then comes Zaif, then comes Mawzu. Time will not permit to go into details. So the second type of difference of opinion in fiqh, besides the criteria, is whether the Hadith is Sahih or Zaif. Few. Third, may be difference in understanding the Hadith. For example, the Hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that after Ruku, the Prophet stood and he kept his hands where they were. So some schools of thought, I'm not mentioning the names purposely, some schools of thought say the Prophet kept his hand on his chest before he went to Ruku, the hands were on the chest. So after Ruku, when they get up, they keep the hand on the chest. The other end must say no, before starting the Salah, where were the hands? The hands were at the side. So when they get up from Ruku, they keep the hands on the sides. So here you understand that the difference is because understanding the Hadith. All of them agree that the Hadith is Sahih, but one Fuqaha agrees that this Hadith refers to where were the hands before going to Ruku. The other Fuqahas agree that it was before starting Salah. So difference in interpreting the Hadith. So one is because of criteria, which is the major difference. Number two is the difference in whether it's a Sahih or Zaif. Number three in understanding the Hadith. Similarly, there can be a difference in understanding the Quranic verse also. For example, the verse of the Quran says that when a woman touches, the wudu breaks. So one fuqaha agrees that physically that breaks the wudu. The Arabic word is masa, coming from the word lamasa. Lamasa has got two meanings in Arabic. One means the sexual touch, one means a physical touch. So one fuqaha takes it as a physical touch, and the physical touch breaks the wudu. The other fuqaha says no, it means sexual touch. So physical touch does not make a wudu. So these differences are there in understanding the meaning of the verse of the Quran. So because of these differences, whether it be difference in criteria, whether it be difference in whether it's a Sahih Hadith, whether it's a difference in understanding the Hadith, whether the difference in understanding the verse of the Quran, because of this, the differences are there, and these differences are minor. We should not fight over it. What we find today, that because of these issues, there are some people who just study for a few months or few years, and they start saying that, okay, my fiqh is the best and the only right one, which is wrong. All these are great fuqahas, we love them all, we respect them all. Even they among themselves, when they differ, they respect it. They agree with that, they view what they say, my view I think is afzal. It is better. That doesn't mean you are wrong. But today, most of you are wrong, I am right. What I say, even I am right. To say I am only right is a big problem. Or you can say, I think this is afzal, this is better. That you can say. But today what we have, no, I am only right, you are wrong. Because of that, there is tension and there is fighting. We Muslims should be united. These are petty issues. The differences are going to be there. There were differences in the Sahabas. We should not fight over it, and we should agree that we agree to disagree. We should not fight over it. And all these issues are not on the major issues. They are minor issues. So I request the Muslim Ummah that we should be united, and we should respect the Aimmas, and we should respect the scholars, and see to it that we follow the Quran and Sahih Hadith as close as possible. Hope that answers the question.